Ever since the foundation of the state, our founders believed that Ireland should take its place among the nations of the world. And we believe that now is our time to double our impact, double our presence on the global stage.
Global Ireland is about Ireland making its mark. This is a country that is more outward looking than any other country in the European Union. We rely on global trade. We rely as a small country on relationships with other countries. That is why the Taoiseach has prioritised doubling Ireland's global impact by 2025. One of the things that makes me most proud is what we do on peacekeeping. Today we have hundreds of troops in southern Lebanon, in UNIFIL, and many, many other highly professional leaders in different parts of the world to ensure people can live in safety. And we're going to expand and grow the contribution that we make through UN structures.
We spend hundreds of millions of euros every year on international development assistance in many countries in Africa and other parts of the world as well. We have a particular commitment to educating women and girls and also in dealing with hunger and malnutrition around the world because of our own experience of the Great Famine.
Ireland historically has a very proud history of working in solidarity with people in developing countries. We've got this real opportunity now to bring about transformation into the future. Let's make sure that we are ambitious enough to eradicate poverty, that we're willing to tackle the scourge of inequality and also climate change.
After 45 years membership of the European Union, Ireland's future is very much at the heart of the European home which we have helped to build. Global Ireland is about strengthening and deepening the relationships that we've formed over the years and growing them even further.
Taking a seat on the UN Security Council is important because for over 60 years now, Ireland has played a leading role at the UN, and as part of the global footprint, we want to step up and take our place at the top table, the Security Council, where we feel we can help shape the world we need.
Our diaspora are our people making a very, very positive impact across the world, and our government is intent on strengthening that community and building even more powerful connections.
The cultural part of this plan is going to be really important. For a lot of people, the first time they hear about Ireland is our literature, our dance, our language, our culture. So we really want to promote that and make sure that's part of how the world sees us.
For the culture sector, this means expanding our global footprint throughout the world. It's going to be doubling it effectively, particularly over the next 7 years. So it's really exciting.
Ireland has an extraordinary reputation for our culture, our heritage, our arts. When I think of some of the amazing Irish writers found here in the National Library, they're recognised across the world.
This is about Team Ireland. It's about everyone working for Ireland and working together to promote Ireland.
This is about pulling together all that Ireland has to offer in a Team Ireland approach that can ensure that we maximise the impact that we can collectively have right across the globe.
It's about Enterprise Ireland, it's about IDEA, working with our embassies right across the globe. It's about seeking out new markets, it's about getting new investors.
IDEA sees the Global Ireland programme as extraordinarily important. IDEA sees a lot of opportunity, both doubling down in existing markets, and we're particularly looking east at new markets.
This programme is about Team Ireland working around the world to make sure that we're maximising the impact for these companies in terms of helping them access new opportunities and grow their global sales.
Ireland's food and drink industry are world leaders in food sustainability. We already export to 180 markets. With the Global Ireland programme, Borbia looks to work with our colleagues overseas to build this brand to be a global one, to build our reputation, to achieve our export growth.
We're going to build on the extraordinary success that we're already having. Tourism figures are going up, despite the fact of Brexit. So we're really looking forward to building on what we already have with a great deal of enthusiasm.
It'll mean we could triple the amount of spend coming in from important emerging markets like China and India.
What this document is about is really laying out how we are going to dramatically expand Ireland's influence across the world.
The plan's been published, implementation has already begun, and I believe this is our time, our opportunity to take our place among the nations of the world and to be a major player on the global stage. And it's all based on our values, on peace, on security, on sustainability, on social justice, promoting human rights, free trade and economic freedom all over the world.